两个团队在设计理念会有所不同，原因是欧洲人他们已经过去了所谓追求物资丰富的这个阶段，中国的消费者对于家居的生活的习惯是完全不同的。
Well, we have a very different approach. I have a very engineering heavy, very manufacturing heavy approach. But he has a very customized, very decoration work heavy approach.
跟海富勒合作做这 PK 赛，就它的功能非常强大。海富勒总有一款配件能够让我在不同的很狭小的空间里面都能把各个空间全部用得干干净净。
There are four hardwares which you won't find in a standard apartment. All of these hardwares have brought a really significant advantage to the project.
是一个18平方的一个房子，当我们把这个家门打开了之后的话，是一个巨大无比的鞋柜，总共可以容纳36双鞋。那么这么短的厨房我们很难用，所以的话我需要有一个空间让它可以有一个延展。所有的锅碗瓢盆在哪呢？在这儿。对，所有的常用的锅，所有的常用的碗筷跟碟全部放在这儿。我们就来到了这个客厅，留意一下所谓的榻榻米，我们所有的杂物都可以放在这一边。看一下升起来这个是个酒柜，这个客厅它的目的是为了一团人可以全部坐在这儿。我们现在爬到2楼去，很多人都在说为什么这么有一个大柜子，留意一下，所有的换季衣物满满当当，随意拉出来。
From the apartment point of view, you start to have a normal clothes rack. You come in and you have your wardrobe with a high hanger. So if you have longer coats, so if you have a dress, a full-size kitchen, we have all the things you would normally want from a proper-size kitchen. You have a smaller table. If you host more people, you can pull it out even further and easily sit 6 people if you want. The restrictions of a shared flat, you don't have the space, no one has an extra bed. And we are lucky that we could integrate the sofa and the bed, because an apartment like this will be in the major cities, it will be in the city centers. So if someone wants to visit a city, Beijing, Shanghai, Shenzhen, they want to stay in the center. You live in the center, why not 3 different? Both projects equally try to achieve one thing. We try to reduce everything as small as possible and still maintain the feeling that you think you have your own apartment. If those projects get more and more implemented successfully, they will change people's perception about smaller space.
我们的目的实际上是为了实现中国的整个的住宅精装产业化的整个链条的达成，而并不仅仅是做一个吉祥户型。